personally know of anyone that has been affected by a distracted driver, whether it's been an injury or a death? Do you also know of anybody that has been the distracted driver in an accident? According to CDC.com, there are an average of 9 people killed and one over 1,000 injured in the United States every single day from distracted drivers. As well as in 2015, according to the CDC, there were over 390,000 people injured and there were over 3,400 people killed from distracted drivers. It is important to make sure that you take away any distractions from yourself while on the road or from others you're in the car with. I personally, from research and from an experience of a close friend of mine, have dealt with distracted driving. Now, my experience was a person was walking their dog alongside the road, and there was a distracted driver that then hit the person. Yes, the person went to the hospital and faced life and death situations. It was a very scary and tough time for me and my family, but we are very lucky she's okay today. We must understand the dangers that distracted driving can impose on every single person on the road. There are 3 different types of distracted driving. First is manual distraction. Now, manual distraction means that there are 1 or no hands on the steering wheel at a given time. A few examples. Eating and drinking are a couple. There are changing radio stations or even just working with your GPS. Second type of distraction is a visual distraction. Visual distraction is when your eyes, they go off the road. You're not paying attention to the road. One example of this would be texting and driving, which everyone seems to think is the biggest distraction, and it is the biggest distraction. Another one is looking at a view. Looking at a view is very hard to pass up sometimes, I can attest, but it is a very big reason of distracted driving. The third form of distracted driving is cognitive. Cognitive distracted driving causes your mind to wander off and lose focus on the road. Now, whether it's talking to a passenger in your car and just focusing on the conversation instead of the road, that's one form of cognitive distracted driving. Road rage, daydreaming, and being under the influence are multiple other ways of distracted driving, cognitive distracted driving. These all have to deal with losing focus on the road and thinking of something else, which can not only harm yourself, other people in the car, or many people around you. Now, ways to prevent distracted driving that I just mentioned. So, this is a football. Now, what I'm gonna say is a stat. And the stat is, if you're driving, say you're sending a text and it takes 5 seconds for you to send that text. And if you're driving at 55 miles an hour, you will be driving the length of a football field blind. So let me say that again. If you're sending a text that takes 5 seconds, it is basically driving a football field blind. That's a scary thought. Now, I don't know if you've ever seen somebody texting while driving, I would assume you have, but just realizing that they're texting and not looking on the road and realizing they haven't even seen where they're going for an entire length of a football field, something's very scary to me. Now, I would say another huge way to prevent these forms of distracted driving is to pull over. I think pulling over is key to almost every single one of these things I listed as a distraction for driving. Whether it is pulling over to send a text, pulling over to take a phone call, pulling over to eat or drink. I mean, it prevents every single one of those. Then you're not driving, you're not putting yourself at harm or anybody else at harm. Now, for taking a view, This goes back to the football field. You might be looking at mountains for 5 seconds. Yes, they are beautiful. But you need to understand the things that you can impose on yourself and others by looking away for that long. Views can wait. I know they might be cool to look at, but you can pull over, you can wait till you have red light. There are many ways to still look at something when you are not driving. You can also pull over to type in the address to where you're going. If you don't know where you're going, don't do it while you're driving. Pull over for a second. Wait till you're at the red light and type it in your phone and keep on going. A third thing to help prevent these distractions while driving. If you're in the car with somebody, have the passenger mess with the AC. Have the passenger type in the address. Now you have to realize, talking to them, you cannot get lost in the conversation with them, or else that's distracting yourself as well. So just ask, can you put the address in? That is another great way to help yourself from becoming distracted on the road. We now have an understanding of the problems, the effects, and the solutions to distracted driving. Now, before going on the road, think, if I'm driving for 10 minutes, is it really worth it to send a text for 5 seconds? No, the harm that you put yourself in, or the people that are in the car with you, or the people that are driving the cars around you, it is not worth it to put their life in danger or yours. Now, watch over others as well. If you get in a car with somebody and you see them texting, say, hey, the text can wait. It's not worth it. According to Nationwide, 74% of people admit to text-related activity while driving. That's an unbelievable amount. 3/4 people admit to using this while driving. Always remember that reminding a friend, family member, or anyone for that matter, can save a life. Don't become a statistic. Lessen the statistics.